随手把玩城市论坛活动这三天，我们要非常感谢各位贵宾以及城市代表们的参与，彼此分享经验、意见交流，凝聚全球把玩城市的能量。也非常感谢高雄市府提供一个交流与合作的互动场域，希望能够延续深化国际把玩城市的友谊。It's wonderful to see everyone again. We hope you've enjoyed the forum just as much as we've enjoyed hosting you. We would like to thank all of our distinguished guests who participated in the Global Harbor Cities Forum. You've all helped to make this first global forum hosted by Kaohsiung a great success. 接下来让我们欣赏一段过去三天来全球把玩城市论坛的影片。And now I'd like to show you a video of the events from the past 3 days.
效率更有活力， 环境能够更永续发展的港湾城市。我想这也是我们高雄发起全球港湾城市论坛最大的目的。大家应该都有丰硕的收获，我们也彼此更加了解，更加喜欢，更加欣赏彼此的不同。哇，这个这样的宽容交流，我们都是好的兄弟，你是我的兄弟，我们是最好的朋友。港湾城市的领导者，当然对于所有的风速风浪，包括世界之间很多的潮流，必然都有非常敏感的这样的嗅觉。港湾城市的领导者，我们认为一定有相当的眼界。同时，所有港湾城市的领导者展现他的自信，来面对很多很多不同的挑战。我们希望能够有创意创新的对策，同时能够带领参与每个国家不同的经济的发展。这几天我们所有的港湾城市港口城市之间有很多很多的互动，让我们很感动。包括高雄市跟巴拿马市签署警戒市，这个中间我们的市长要挥了20几个将近30个小时。还有我们有来自丹麦哥本哈根，我们有来自法国马赛、英国利物浦，我们有来自秘鲁城市的市长，哇，我们都非常非常的感动。我们跟马来西亚雪兰莪州签署数位内容议程中心，还有穆斯林清真认证合作的备忘录。我们在市长的圆桌论坛，我们听到每一个不同国家他们分享港湾城市治理的经验，还有我们有哪些可以合作的项目。港湾城市面对共同的难题，环保的问题，各种海洋永续化的问题，我们希望透过互相的合作共同来面对这些挑战。在这个活动的期间，我也分别跟19个城市的代表再见面。我们希望彼此之间能够更多的交流互动，当然希望增加未来我们合作的机会。这次的论坛只是港湾城市合作的第一步，我们要把这里学到的经验给我们自己2年的时间来付诸实践。2年以后我们再度聚会，来迎接第二届全球港湾城市论坛，希望有更多更多民间的参与，包含文化、经贸、技术层面，我们希望有这些实质的交流。明年的10月，我们将举办2017高雄生态交通全球的盛典，这是一个人所属生态交通联盟。我想跟他的会员城市，我们共同来举办，目的是希望未来所期待，我们所期待的低碳、节能、生态交通的形态，透过盛典的活动，让民众感受生态交通的进步。好。 住，让社区，让城市不断的提升。我们在这里非常诚恳邀请现场所有国内外的好朋友，明年能够再次邀请大家到高雄来参与我们2017高雄生态交通全球的盛宴。水源市，韩国水源市提供给我们很多他们办理生态交通非常好的经验。我们希望高雄市在亚洲地区，我们是第二个来参办的城市，真的欢迎大家鼓励高雄，给高雄机会。最后我在这里要非常非常的感谢这次活动规划所有的团队，还有我们很多很多志工朋友热情付出，真的高雄有这么多美丽的志工真好。我们也展现高雄非常热情的一面，让所有的每一个城市的市长、副市长，所有的贵宾有那种宾至如归的感觉。我相信这位市长、各位城市的代表，马上都要回到自己的国家。谢谢你们贡献你们的经验，你们参与高雄市我们港湾城市的论坛。这是历史性的一次，我代表高雄市278万的市民跟大家说，多把多下，高雄感谢你，高雄谢谢你。我们有一点舍不得跟各位说再见，但是我一定要跟大家说，我们再见，后会有期。高雄或者在世界任何的港湾城市，我们都为了一个美好的未来在努力。谢谢大家，高雄感谢你，谢谢，多谢，
非常感谢市长为我们支持，谢谢市长，非常感谢市长，请市长先回座休息。好，紧接着我要为大家宣读12016全球港湾城市代表们所达成的一个共识。那未来全球港湾城市将朝着这个方向迈进，持续推动港湾城市的发展。And now I'd like to read to you the 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum Statement, an agreement reached by participants of this year's forum.This is the 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum Statement, the preface. The 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum was held in Kaohsiung City on September 6th to September 8th and attracted more than 600 participants from about 50 cities across the globe. The forum provided a platform for harbor cities to address both the challenges and opportunities they face.The mayors and leading representatives of harbor cities have previously identified these challenges and opportunities as the most critical. They urgently needed to be discussed and tackled together. Along with the 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum, the mayor's roundtable was also convened. The roundtable was hosted by Mayor Chen Zhu and was held on September 7th in Kaohsiung.Director General James Huang of Taiwan's new Southbound Policy Office moderated the roundtable. It was a by-invitation event for mayors and the leaders of harbor cities to exchange knowledge and experiences concerning urban governance and harbor developments, as well as to deepen collaboration among the city governments and port authorities of the Global Harbor Cities Forum Network. 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum Statement lists the concrete achievements.The Mayor's Roundtable. The statement was officially announced and signed by the participating mayors and city leaders of harbor cities on the morning of September 8th, 2016. The statement will serve as reference for the future development of harbor cities. The specific statement principles agreed by the participants for the future are as follows. Vibrant harbor cities. We believe that successful city and port developments can become engines of urban, regional, and national economic growth. This requires both city governments and port authorities to find the right mix of diversified economic functions that render harbor cities economically vibrant and sustainable. Being part of the ever-changing global economy, it is imperative for harbor cities to identify new industrial opportunities. Examples are the circular economy and renewable energy. These processes can build on existing assets and infrastructure. Green and smart harbor cities. We seek to ensure that our harbor cities remain safe, livable, and sustainable places for all inhabitants and visitors. We also acknowledge that mitigating negative urban and port impacts is essential for the long-term advancement of harbor cities. We agree that actors involved in the development of harbor cities must develop proactive strategies to address increasing threats to human health, biodiversity, and economic well-being that are associated with growth. We believe that the concept of smart harbor city, which combines smart technologies in an urban and environmental context, provides great potential for creating a livable harbor city that flourishes economically. Positive synergy between ports and cities. We recognize the policy dilemmas between ports and cities, since port authorities and city governments do not necessarily share the same interests, goals, and perceptions of challenges or policies. We encourage ports and cities to find the positive synergy between diverging perspectives and priorities. For example, it is beneficial to attract high value added port-related employment and to develop mixed urban waterfronts with room for port functioning. Integrated planning framework for harbor cities. We acknowledge the need for an integrated planning framework to resolve the mismatch between ports and cities. The harbor city is a complex territorial, social, and industrial organization whose development trajectory is determined by a number of stakeholders. Each of the stakeholders has a different set of interests and motivation. We believe that joint planning efforts can help stakeholders to avoid unnecessary tensions, facilitate collaborations based on the recognition of their interdependence, identify issues to be dealt with collectively, and ensure that both ports and cities are aligned with the direction of the positive future developments of harbor cities. And finally, the dialogue between harbor cities. We shall continue to work together through dialogue with other harbor cities because we face many important and common challenges. The challenges include the impacts of mega shifts, energy prices, and the transition to alternative fuels, environmental challenges, and the ever-changing economic situation. We call on harbor cities across the globe to work together to address common challenges, to support each other, and to adopt the good practices of our fellow harbor cities. And that is the 2016 Global Harbor Forum Series Statements. And to sign and to seal this statement, I would like to welcome our representatives to the stage for a signing ceremony. Please come forward to the stage as I call your name. I would also like to tell you that there are 10 representatives who also signed the statement, but they're unable to be here today to join us in the closing ceremony. And they are as follows. You can see it on the screen. That would be Deputy Secretary General of the Tainan City Government, Mr. Liu Shizhong. The State Minister for Local Governments of Traffic Management and Flood Mitigation of Penang, Malaysia, Mr. Kong Yao Chow. The Director of Osaka Port and Harbor Bureau from Osaka, Japan, Hiromu Yaguchi. Deputy Mayor of Tilo, Mr. Lin Yongfa. The Vice Governor from Chiba Prefecture of Japan, Mr. Wataru Takahashi, the Senior Counselor of Selling Borse EXO, Standing Committee Chairman of Investment, Industry and Trade, Mr. Tang Chen Kim, Vice Governor for Mie Prefecture, Ichi Ishigaki, the Mayor of Kohoku, Mr. Shen Guangfu, the Mayor of Palau, Peru, Juan Sotomayor Garcia, and the Mayor of Yangon, Myanmar, Moon Moon-seok. Unfortunately, they're unable to attend our closing ceremony today. But now I would like to welcome our representatives to come to the stage for the signing ceremony. First, let us welcome the Deputy Mayor from Yiland, Mr. Lin Fenglong. 欢迎林处长来到我们的台上。欢迎林处长。And now I'd like to welcome the Managing Director from Honolulu, USA, Mr. Roy Amemiya. And now let's welcome the Deputy Director General from Kota Kinabalu, Malaysia, Mr. Bahari Haji Hassan. Let's give them a round of applause. Please sign the tablet with the pen provided on the side. Please provide your signature on the tablet for us. 三位全市代表现在要为我们在这个平板上面签署他们的名字。Thank you very much. Thank you for signing for us, Mr. Speaker. And we have the next group of representatives who will be on our stage for the signing ceremony. Let me welcome the mayor from Male, from Mountains, Mr. Mohammed Shihab. Let us welcome the mayor from Panama City, Jose Blandon. And then we welcome the director from the Port of Antwerp International from Belgium, Christophe Watershoek. And just as a kind reminder, I think you need to press it a little bit harder for your signatures to work on the tablet. Please sign your names. Thank you very much for joining us in the signing ceremony, and please do sign your name on the tablet with the pen provided on the side. Let's give them a warm applause. Thank you. And we'll take your seat. And now for the next group of representatives I'd like to invite to the stage. Let us welcome the Councillor of Copenhagen City Council from Denmark, Mr. Jacob Hugard. Let us welcome the Vice Chairman from Da Nang, Vietnam, Nguyen Ngoc Thuan. Chair from Liverpool, United Kingdom, Mr. Gary Miller. And now let's welcome the Deputy Mayor from Marseille, France, Mr. Roland Luke. A very warm welcome to all of you all, and thank you for joining us. Please do sign your name on the packet. Thank you very much. Let's give them a round of applause. You may take your seats. Thank you. And now for our last group of representatives to the stage, let us welcome the mayor from Suwon, South Korea, Mr. Tae Yong-young. Let us welcome the Deputy Mayor from Kobe, Japan, Noriyoshi Okaguchi. Let us welcome the Mayor from Baton Rouge, United States, Mr. Melvin Lee Hogan. And last but not least, let us welcome our host, Kaohsiung Mayor Chen Xu. 欢迎市长来到台前为我们签署这一份港湾城市论坛的宣言。Please sign your name, 请签名。And now I'd like to invite all of our guests to the stage again for a toast and a group photo to conclude this year's Harbor Forum. Please come to the stage as I call your names. Let me welcome once again the Deputy Mayor from Yilan, Li Dongru. 欢迎计划处的处长，宜兰县的李东如处长。Let me welcome the Managing Director from Honolulu, USA, Mr. Roy Amemiya. Let us welcome the Deputy Director General from Kota Kinabalu, Malaysia, Mr. Bahari Haji Hassan. Let me welcome the Deputy Governor from Jakarta, Indonesia, Sukarno Sutopo. Let me welcome the Mayor from Malé, Maldives, Mohamed Shihab. Let me welcome the mayor from Panama City, Jose Blandon. And now let us welcome the director of Port of Antwerp International, Belgium, Christophe Larchi. Please help me welcome the vice chairman from Haiphong, Vietnam, Lei Sun Song. Let us welcome the mayor from Brisbane, Australia, Graham Kirk. Let us welcome the manager of government relations from Tenuku Development, Auckland, from New Zealand, Angelica Cutler. Let's welcome the executive manager to the Access and Transport from the city of Sydney, Australia, Rio B. Cooper. Let's welcome the councillor of Copenhagen City from Denmark, Jacob Cooper. Let's welcome the vice chairman from Da Nang, Vietnam, Luan Nguyen Quan. Let's welcome the vice mayor from Liverpool, United Kingdom, Mr. Gary Miller. Let's welcome the deputy mayor from Versailles, France, Mr. Roland Boone. Let us welcome the mayor from Suwon, South Korea, Tai Yong-yun. Let us welcome the deputy mayor from Kobe, Japan, Noriyoshi Okaguchi. Let us welcome the mayor from Baton Rouge, United States, Ms. Melvin Lee Hogan. And last but not least, let us give a warm welcome to our host, Kaohsiung Mayor Chen Xu. 让你最热烈的掌声欢迎我们大家的陈菊陈市长。好的，非常感谢各位贵宾，请各位贵宾们举起手上的杯子，为港湾城市的未来举杯祝贺。Please raise your glasses. A toast to the success of this year's forum and many, many more to come. Cheers. Cheers.And that concludes the 2016 Global Harbor Cities Forum. 也请我们的摄影师为我们所有的代表们拍照留念。我是日韩，期待各位贵宾下次再相会。高雄 City Government will be hosting another Harbor City Forum in 2018.
这次全球的港湾城市论坛，我们请了非常多的国际的专家来给我们分享每一个港湾的城市在做工业转型的时候怎么样利用会展的力量来协助城市各项的贸易、各项的产业、各项的人才，甚至包括整个城市的 这个未来的这个有序经营 ，MICE 产业怎么样在里面扮演一个重要的角色？那我们从这两天的分享里面呢，得到了非常多的国际的经验。我相信对高雄市在未来发展会展产业的时候，这是一个非常大的鼓舞以及非常重要的动力。我想会展产业对高雄在过去所创造的产值，可以从我们高雄展览馆在未来两年的表现看得出来。2014年4月份高雄展览馆正式启用之后，在过去的两年，它的展览的数量从18个增强到今年的38个，在会议的成长部分更是100%的成长。所以我们可以由这个例子来看到，一个城市有了新的会展中心之后，这个会展中心就像一个贸易的平台，它可以协助每一项的产业很快速的发展，创造出新兴的产业，同时可以利用会议方面的功能带来很多的薪资。当然最重要对一个城市来讲是孕育培养城市国际竞争人才一个最重要的基地。这次来参与的东南亚国家来了12个，那刚好高雄市非常积极的我们自我定位为这个前进南向的重要的基地。我想在会展的部分，将来也在这个部分呢，我们可以跟很多的东南亚国家共同创造出更新的机会。会展产业本来就是一个国际性的事业，我们形容展览就像一个 flying house， 每一个参展者把他的产品带到某一个城市、某一个国家去参展，所以它本身就是一个非常非常国际化的平台。我相信利用国际的会展来协助高雄市，或者我们来搭配到这个城市由工业转型到未来创意城市的发展的时候，会展扮演非常重要角色。同时呢，它非常重要另外一个扮演的角色就是跟观光结合。那会展带来和观光不一样的人潮就是商务的交流人口。我相信这样的一个新兴的这个观光人口，对高雄市整个发展大 mix 的概念来讲，这是未来我们非常重要的目标。